When I think back to the late 80s and early 90s, this show, Married with Children, was one of my favorites. I totally identified with Al Bundy. I'm not sure why. When the show premiered on Fox in 1987, I was neither married or had children. I did, however, work in retail, and so did Al, so maybe that was it. Married with Children ran on the Fox TV network for 11 seasons over the course of 10 years, and the show was the exact opposite of the standard family sitcom that was so prevalent at the time. The Bundy family were a truly dysfunctional lot, and their misery resulted in a ton of comedic hijinks, and I'll go ahead and say it, fun. Yep, it was a lot of fun to watch these folks go at each other. The cast of the show was absolutely phenomenal. Ed O'Neill, Katie Sagal, Christina Applegate, and David Faustino played the Bundy family. And then there were the neighbors, Steve and Marcy Rhodes, young professionals who looked at the Bundys with more than just a little bit of disdain. And it wasn't long before Al Bundy found his natural-born enemy in Marcy Rhodes. You know, Al pretty much embodied everything that Marcy found distasteful in a man. I've got to say that Amanda Bearse made the most of her role. Truthfully, she was so much fun as Marcy, always whispering in Peggy's ear about something that Al was doing wrong, or worse. Yep, Marcy was a character that audiences were destined not to root for. But somehow, Amanda managed to still make Marcy a character that fans of the show could really rally around. By the way, if you haven't seen Amanda in the 1985 movie Fright Night, well, then you've got some required homework. This movie, starring Roddy McDowall, William Ragsdale, Chris Sarandon, and Amanda, well, it's just so much fun. Sure, it's a little bit scary and a teeny tiny bit gory, but the movie often goes for your funny bone, and quite frankly, I've always felt that that's the perfect way to make a horror movie. Serve up some laughs to your audience, and then shock the heck out of them. So, getting back to Marcy. As I've already mentioned, for the first couple of seasons, she was married to Steve Rhodes, played by David Garrison. But then things got really crazy when Steve left, and Jefferson Darcy, played by the great Ted McGinley, entered the picture. Yep, Marcy Rhodes had all of a sudden become Marcy Darcy. So what about this feud? Were there really hard feelings between Ed O'Neill and Amanda Bearse? Were there moments when the two of them would be at odds with each other, perhaps even speaking to each other using their not-so-quiet voices? Well, the truth is that yes, Ed and Amanda, particularly after the first couple of seasons, did not always see eye to eye and get along on set, and as a result, they certainly didn't hang out as friends when production stopped. Amanda has addressed this numerous times in various interviews at Comic-Cons and other events, and has said that things became even more volatile as she found herself playing double duty, both as Marcy and as the show's director behind the cameras. And Ed, to his credit, has acknowledged the same thing, of course with a slightly different perspective, in his interviews that you can find online here on YouTube that were conducted by the Academy of American Television. The reality is that these two actors in real life have some similarities personality-wise to the characters that they played on the beloved sitcom, and so as you might expect, there might be some differences of opinion from time to time. Getting back to those interviews with Amanda, it should be mentioned that she is always quick to mention what a wonderful actor Ed O'Neill is, and based on the interviews that I watched with Ed, it's clear to me that he has a ton of respect for Amanda's work as both an actor and director as well. Truth be told, they're just very different people. If you think about it, it's really kind of odd to expect that everyone on the Married with Children set would be the best of friends. Life just doesn't work that way, and it certainly didn't here. So, end of the day, was there a feud? Well, I guess it depends on how you define a feud. Ed and Amanda didn't always get along. And because of that, they don't interact with each other much, if at all these days. I'm not sure I'd call that a feud though, but I know that others have. I'll leave it at that, and I'll let you make up your mind now that you know the truth. Alright, now it's your turn. Please share your memories in the comments section, and while you're at it, I would love a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and I would be absolutely honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.